Hi everyone! Last time I did talk about Vercel and the deployment of Next.js application directly through Vercel, so by connecting it in the Vercel application and pointing to the GitHub repository, so it was pretty straightforward. But I promised as well to have a look at some other method. This other method is related to GitHub Actions. So by using GitHub Actions, we are able to deploy our application to the Vercel. This means that at any time, if you would like to add new code and then commit it to main, then your code will be deployed to Vercel, but after some steps. So in GitHub Actions, we are able to define several different steps. What are these steps? These steps will be today building of npm run build, linting, npm run lint, and then deploying the application into production. What I will omit is testing, because this is something that will require more focus on the code that we have in our code base. And as you remember from the last episode, it's just taken from the Next.js template. So this is something that we will skip for today, but I will mention it in the end of this video. So stay until the end, how to handle it with the tests and not only unit ones, but as well with deploying something to preview deployment and then running the end-to-end tests and afterwards deploying the stuff to the production. Here we go. And we start our development from the last state of our application. There was one change that I made in comparison to the previous version. So to simplify the deployment, I just took out everything what is related to Next.js project into the root folder of the repository. This will allow us way easier GitHub pipeline creation and then execution of the code. And that's why I changed it. So this is something that is different in comparison to the last episode. Okay, here is our repository. And what we need to do right now is to go to Vercel. As you can see, I deleted the previous version. I didn't want it. We start from scratch. So what we are going to do is, like before, we add a new project. So we have an access to this deploy to Vercel. As you remember from the last video, we gave this access here. So we need to import it. And when we import it, there is nothing else to set. Here, it automatically selects Next.js. And that's great. We deploy it. And after the deployment is done, so you can see at the moment it's building, then it will run checks and assign domains. This will be, of course, Vercel domains, because we are on a hobby project level. There is no specific domain assignment planned for this video. And of course, I will skip it until it's done. Here we are. Our Next.js application is deployed to Vercel. If I go now to the dashboard, I can see that there is the deployment which was created here. And if I go to this deploy to Vercel app, I should see the application. And as you can see, I can see it. It was not immediate. I had to wait several seconds, but now we are here inside the application. And as you can see from the previous video, we did a change to the title of the tab. So this is goodbye our app. And we continue from that point. What we have to do at the moment is we need to unplug the Git repository from this rep, because now if you add anything to your main repository, the deployment will be triggered automatically. And this is exactly something what we don't want to in this video. You have to go to settings, and in the settings, there is a Git tab. In Git tab, you can see that our app is connected to repository that we created, and we have to disconnect it. Of course, it will ask about this removal. We confirm it. And now we are ready to get back to GitHub Actions and start creating the deployment YAML. Let's navigate to GitHub. And in GitHub, you can see that there is nothing that changed. We have this connection to our Versal app. So this is the old one. This is not existing anymore. So it was exactly when we did this connection, direct connection to Versal in the previous episode. And now let's get back to Visual Studio. And from the Visual Studio perspective, we are going to see what we can do to allow GitHub Actions to deploy our application to Versal. First of all, you need to create on the root level. This is very important that it will be here on the root level, the GitHub folder. And inside the GitHub folder, we need to create workflows folder. And inside the workflows folder, we create a YAML, which will be called deployment YAML. And inside this YAML, we will be putting the actions that we would like to run from the GitHub Actions pipeline. First, we will configure the main part of our GitHub pipeline. It's called build, test, and deploy application to Versal. We can drop this test because we won't do it today. And then what we have here in this YAML are the variables that are very important. I will let you know in the end of creation of YAML where you can find it. And this secrets, which we have here, we will use for connecting to Versal. So what we have here is the organization ID that is assigned to your account as a user ID in Versal, and project ID that is assigned directly to your project when you are creating Versal. Then we are defining that on push to main branch, we would like to run our workflow. And this is the first step of configuring the deployment YAML. Okay, when we are ready with that, we have to create some jobs. And our jobs here will be, first of all, the linked one. So we will lint our application. And what we have here is the name of this step. Then we have the environment on which it will be run. So we have Ubuntu. And from the steps perspective, we will use the newest actions. And for run, we will do just npm install and npm run lint. That's it. This is for linting. Next step that we are going to do, and which we will place here, is build of the application. And what we have here in the build is, again, we will run it on Ubuntu. We will use the newest GitHub actions, and then we are going to run npm run build. So this will build our application for the production usage. And these are two steps that we need to have before we deploy the production environment. And now I will put the code which is responsible for building, deploying our application to Versal. And here I paste it. I prepared this code before. So what we are going to have here is the deployment of production. This is the name of our build. Then we are using again Ubuntu, and the steps which we are using repeat from the GitHub actions. We are using the newest version, and then the fun begins, because here we are installing first the Versal CLI by running npm install Versal latest. Then we are pulling this Versal environment information, and for that we will need a Versal token. I will show from where to get it, how to configure it in Versal app. Then we are going to build project artifacts with the Versal command and deploy these artifacts to Versal. So this is the last step that allows us to show our application to the world. Before we go to Versal application, I would like to say that this deployment of production should wait, and it should wait for two jobs that we have here. This is lint and build. Only after they are successful, it should deploy the production. So here I am putting this two jobs. So you are taking this information from here, and this is the way how you can configure it. When you have tests, you can as well add here tests after a comma, and any job that you will configure, you can put it here, and this will make sure that the application will be deployed to production only if everything is green. And this way you can follow this continuous deployment. Let's go to VersaLab. Here we are. And as you probably remember from the Visual Studio Code, we need three things. We need Versal Org ID, Versal Project ID, and Versal Token. And these things will be configured under repository secrets in GitHub. Let's start with the org ID. I just go to the settings of my account. On the general tab here, you have your organization ID. I am copying it, and this thing I need to save, store under Versal org ID inside GitHub repository secrets. So in GitHub, I go to secrets and variables, and here I just go to actions, and I see here I have already created these three secrets that you are going to put as well inside your application, just to speed it up a bit. And here I am going just to paste it. Okay, it's done. Now what I would like to do is to grab this project ID and token. So here is the path to token. And you can name it as you wish. I will just call it deploy to Versal. And I select scope. So I will give the full account access, and the expiration date will be 1 day. I am creating this token. I can copy it now. I go back to GitHub repository secrets, and I have to configure it. So again, I updated it. And the last thing which we need to do is taking this project ID. So project ID is inside your project. So it's called deploy to Versal on my side. And if you go into settings, then inside settings, you will find it here. So you copy it. You go back to GitHub actions, then update the secret. And great, we have all the secrets set up right now. So we are ready to commit our pipeline to the main repository. And then we will observe what will happen out of it. Maybe we'll have some mistake. I hope that there will be no mistake. However, you never know. Good. So this is something that I will put now in the repository. So probably as you remember from the last video, I am using Gitkraken. And here from the Gitkraken perspective, I will say integration of GitHub Actions pipeline. Okay, I stage our file, and now I am able to commit it and push it. Now I pushed it from the Gitkraken. So what we should see is already in GitHub on actions that it started. As you can see as well in this picture, first we are running this lint and build, and this deployment of the production waits for the successful action from linting and building. If we go now to the Versal account, to our project, we will see that nothing happens at the moment. So it was created 15 minutes ago. If we go inside, we still see the application that we had before. So here there is nothing that deploys, and you see it. This is the last commit that I did before this video. And this was really moving to the main structure, the root folder of the GitHub repository. And now I can see that something failed. So the linting failed. Let's go to the Visual Studio application and let's check what is going on here, if we are able to see any issues. So it shows no issues. Let's get back to GitHub repo, and it looks like it was failing because of multiple build pipelines which were accessing it. So in the second run here, you can see that the build and linting went all fine and the application was deployed to production. So if I go now to the production environment, you can see that it was updated 2 minutes ago by me, and the branch on which this Vercel deployment is running is this integration of GitHub Actions pipeline. So everything went fine here. And let's make another check. We will change something here, and based on that, we will see if it works or not. So let's go to the pages, and in pages, let's say we did it. Let's commit it to our main. Change the title of the page. I commit it, push it. So again, we go to GitHub, and inside GitHub in Actions, we should see another run, as you can see it here. In deploy to Vercel, we don't see it yet because it's not deployed yet, it's not ready. So afterwards, this will be uploaded to the Vercel as a new fresh deployment. And this is the way how you can achieve this continuous deployments. In the meantime, I would like to show you how you can add end-to-end tests, preview environment, and so on. Because probably you spotted it before, we have here this section of preview deployments. I won't be creating it today, but it's very simple. So you can go to Visual Studio Code, and here inside this YAML file, you can add another step, and this another step will be related to the deployment of the preview environment, and it's almost the same as this deployment of production. Let's add it. We have this deployment of the preview. I pasted it here. You see the name is a bit different. Again, I am running it on the Ubuntu, and here I am saying that it first needs this linting and building, and here in production I can say now that it needs this deploy preview. And only after this is successfully deployed, we are going to deploy as well the production. If there is an error in deployment of preview, there will be no deployment into production. And here, from what you can see, it's the same. So you are installing this Vercel CLI, pulling the Vercel environment information, and here is the change. So we are defining here that we want a preview environment and not a production. This is the only step. And of course, if you would like to, you can add some other step which will run on this deploy preview environment. And this can be some kind of end-to-end tests that you will prepare. And this end-to-end tests can use, for example, the Playwright, or can use Cypress or whatever else. And here we will see that this one will just run on this preview deployment because of a new secret that we have, and this is this Vercel preview alias. So you can see it inside the Vercel app. You can check how it's called. This you can put, of course, in secrets of your GitHub repository as well, to just have it here. And when you have it, if we go here to this deploy to Vercel, you will see, in the meantime, you see this the refactor took place. So this change of the title of the page. So if we are now going here to this deploy to Vercel, we see this title, we did it, perfect. And here you will be able to see your preview environment that was deployed. So all the details. If you don't go with GitHub Actions, you can as well configure Vercel that you would like just to have preview deployment, and then based on that you can say, okay, promote to production. This is some kind of step if you don't want to run any pipeline. But from the real world scenario, it rarely happens, and that's why I showed you how to achieve it with GitHub Action. Let me know, how did you like today's episode? Did you like this continuous deployment approach that you are able to configure your GitHub Actions pipeline to first lint, build, of course, tests, then preview, then run end-to-end tests, then deploy to production? So of course, everything here goes automatically. You don't need to click anything, just commit and push to main. And from that perspective, everything else is taken care by GitHub Actions. If you have any questions, just put a comment under this video. If you think there is something that is missing here, I can as well cover in one of the next videos. Let me know as well if you use continuous deployments on a daily basis or not. This is the simplest way to run your application here with this continuous deployments. But of course, if you would like to have more policies, rules, and so on, this will require a little bit of more configuration. And then using, for example, Canary releases in our deployment pipeline and then migrating traffic like 5, 10, 15% and so on to the new version of the application. Thanks a lot for watching today's video. Don't forget to subscribe and see you next week.